back friends. Today we are going to talk about how to implement centralized exception handling using Spring Boot. Building exception handler. I think you remember about this class. They say this class I used for implementing Spring Boot validation also. Okay, now I am using custom validation. When I use a Spring Boot validation framework, I was using this class. This is a method we need to use for Spring Boot validation framework. Now I am not at all using this method for registration flow. Definitely I am going to use this method for other scenarios. If you want to implement a centralized exception handling, we need to use response entity exception handler. This class, whatever class I am using, that class should extended from this class. This class provided by Spring Boot. Then this class must be annotated with controller advice, then rest controller annotation. Apart from this, we need to create a separate method for each exception handling. Okay, for example, if you want to handle exception, these are general exception, right? Everybody know. If you want to handle this exception type, we need to create a separate method. Invalid input exception. This exception created by me. This is for validating registration flow. Whatever attribute, whatever request you are sending to the backend system, before that I want to validate all mandatory field is available or not. If it is any attribute, if any attribute missing, I want to throw invalid input exception. Whenever throw invalid input exception, this method invoked by our Spring Boot framework. Okay. Whenever throw exception in our application, the Spring Boot exception handling framework call this method. This method is generic method. This method is common for all the places. Wherever exception throws in our system, those places this method invoked. Wherever invalid input exception throws in our system, in those places this method get invoked by our Spring Boot application. So these are common methods for all the places. These are common method for all the places. Like that resource not found. Let's say I want to find customer, I want to find employee, I want to find vendor. If vendor is not available, I want to say vendor is not found. If employee is not available, I want to say employee is not found. If customer is not found, I want to say customer is not found. In three different scenario, I don't want to handle different exception. This one method is enough. Wherever resource not found exception throws, in that places this method get invoked. Okay. When you look at these methods, finally I am throwing response entity. Instead of response entity, I am passing error message and passing status code. This information displayed in client side. This information displayed in client side. Now I am going to show one small program by throwing exception. When after seeing that, you will clearly understand how to use this method. Let's go into the demo now. I'm going to create one test endpoint. Test slash one path variable. Input. I'll say input. Okay. Then input. Here also input. I'll going to remove everything here. I'll keep this. If input equal to equal in the case of yes, then I want to say this. Here I want to say response message equal to new response message, response message dot set message. No, set class type new string of success. Okay, now I'm passing this response here. Okay, if it is input is yes, I am saying success. If the input variable does not have yes, other than yes, I want to throw exception. Throw new, just normal exception. You have entered invalid input. Okay, this is a very simple program to understand our exception handling framework. Okay, whenever call this endpoint test slash input, what is the endpoint? API private users slash test, then I want to pass input. If the input is yes, I want to say success. If input is other than yes, I want to throw new exception. Whenever say throw new exception, what will happen? Your Spring Boot framework call this method, automatically call this method. Now this exception object contain this message, right? So that message I am taking here. I have created one error message class. This is our own error message class. Here I am having two attribute, string error message, local datetime. This I want to populate here whatever error message throwing by the exception. That error message I want to populate here. Then I want to populate current date and time. That's it. Here I am throw new exception. Your Spring Boot framework call this method automatically. Now this exception class having this message. This message. Okay. Now that message I am taking here. Error message equal to new error message of, I am passing that exception message as a first argument of my error message constructor. Then second argument I am passing utils.currentDateTime. The error message class I am not defining, I am not implementing any constructor, but I am here saying all or constructor, at all or constructor. Meaning of this constructor is it will create automatically constructor like this. I already explained that. For new people, I am saying this. So this is the constructor I am calling here. Through error message equal to new error message. I am passing actual error message and the current date and time. See, the same constructor I am calling here, but I don't want to define like this. Because I am using Lombax framework. Lombax framework create this constructor automatically at runtime because of this annotation. This annotation coming from Lombax. When you say at all orgs constructor, whatever field available inside the class, for using that field, automatically our Lombax framework create our constructor. Okay, so we don't have to define this. Now I am passing the two argument here, then this error message I am passing inside a response entity, return new response entity, I am passing this error message, then I am saying internal server error. This response will print in client side, will return in client side as a error response. Okay, now we are going to see the demo. Now our expectation is if input is yes, this message will display success. If input is yeah, and other than yes, this displayed as a error message. Okay, I am getting some error. Let's see what's the error. Actually I made a mistake. We should not put dollar. We need to say braces input. That's it. Start the application now. Server is started now. Now I am going to invoke this endpoint. Test, I want to say yes. Yes is a happy path. So get mapping, right? I want to use get mapping. See success. Response class type equal to success. So my success is printing here. Now I want to say something other than yes. Let's say no. See, you have entered invalid input. You have entered invalid input. Then current date and time is printing. So whenever this exception is happening, automatically our Spring Boot exception framework call appropriate method from here and then display that response, display this error message as a response in the client side. That is the magic of Spring Boot error handling. We don't have to use try and catch all the places. I am not at all using try and catch here. See here. Let's I'll go to create another one. Test 2. Now test 2. Then I'm going to say number. Now I want to say input integer num. The same variable I'm going to use. If num equal to 1, I want to say success. Other than 1, I want to say invalid input, invalid number. I want to say invalid number. I'm going to restart the server. Test 2, I want to pass 1. 1 is a valid number. So it gives success. If you pass other than 1, so invalid number. Now this particular exception object getting passed here. I'm constructing error message using that value and returning that message as a response entity with the internal server error. See here, internal server error. That message is printing here. So how easy to handle exception handling in the Spring Boot. We don't have to use try and catch all the places. We have to define our exception implementation in the one place we can reuse across your application. This is the magic of Spring Boot exception handling. I hope you people understand the way of handling exception, handling exception in Spring Boot. I'm going to remove this. Now we're going to see our real-time scenario. Sorry friends, the lot of squirrels shouting surrounding my home. I'm not able to record. I'll continue this exception handling framework in the next video. Until then, bye-bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel? Please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.